Good morning and welcome to Hebron Christian Church. We're delighted to have everyone with us today. We're excited to be able to come to you in more than one format. We're able to live stream, which is something that's become a bit of a norm around the world now. And we've been a part of a very exciting thing in that we have a live stream format as well. We have an opportunity also to walk in the building and see each other face to face and give someone a hug and be a part of that as well. And that just feels grand. Things are more back to normal every day. We have prayer request cards that are available there at the pews. You may also certainly call in a request to us at any time. We have a prayer team that will be at your fingertips. An opportunity for a chain of prayer warriors to be a part of your concern and your prayer. It feels good to know that someone's praying for you. We have a reminder of our ways of giving today, an opportunity to give in person, certainly. Opportunity to visit our website, and there's an online giving site there. It's handy at your just a fingertip away. You can also text a dollar amount to 84321, and that's a way now to give as well. And mail certainly is always wonderful. Being able to give at this time and lift someone else up is a great way to improve your
church. It's a good day to be in the house of the Lord. Amen. Well, we are beginning a new series of messages titled Conspiracy of Kindness, inspired by the book of the same title, which challenges us to a new way of thinking about evangelism. So evangelism is really about sharing the truth about Jesus in a very clear way and helping others to come and know him. And sometimes all of that makes us very, very nervous because we think, well, you know, I don't really know enough about the Bible to talk to people about Jesus. Or, man, you know what? Every time I try to talk about Jesus, people start to get uncomfortable and this wall just kind of goes up. And so I don't know what to do when that happens, so I just don't talk too much about Jesus. Or we think, well, my relationship with Jesus is private and personal, and I'm just not the kind of person to be vocal about that part of my life. And you see, sometimes we put pressure, we put these expectations on ourselves that God never intended for us to carry. See, I don't believe that God expects every one of us to be Bible scholars or to throw a wrecking ball at someone who puts up a wall in conversation or to be someone who compartmentalizes Jesus in our lives. I do believe with all my heart that God calls us to live our lives in such a way that the fingerprints of Jesus can be clearly seen by those around us. And that doesn't mean that we'll do everything right. It doesn't mean that we'll be perfect. We'll never go through difficult times. But it does mean that even when we fail or fall or struggle, that the God of love and grace and peace and hope still walks with us and shines on us. Even as we struggle with our humanness, we can be a testimony that points people to Jesus. See, the last commandment that Jesus gave on earth was to go and make disciples of all nations. In other words, show people Jesus and help them to be reconciled to him. And God intends for the message of the gospel to be spoken and shown. And now, studies and surveys have indicated that only about 10% of Christ followers are naturally gifted in evangelism. In other words, 90% of us are not really that great at sharing the truth about Jesus to those around us. But every one of us is still created and called by God to be part of that great commission, that mandate to show people Jesus and to help them be reconciled with him. And we cannot retreat from sharing the message of the gospel just because we don't feel confident or comfortable. So the only point of negotiation is, what approach should we take? You see, the message, The reality that all have sinned and fall short of the righteous life God calls us to, but Jesus came to pay the sin debt in full and to reconcile us to God, that Jesus stepped across eternity to enter into humanness. Jesus, who was fully God, became fully man and walked among us. He lived a very real life and he died a very real death on the cross. His body broken, his blood shed for us, made a way for us to know God intimately, to be reconciled with him, to draw close to him. And that reality brings healing and life. And we are to be ambassadors of Christ, helping others to know the truth and to come into relationship with Jesus. And Jesus changes everything. Yes? And so we stand on that truth. We stand on the blood of Jesus. And that message of the gospel does not change. But the way that we communicate that message, the way that we share Jesus, the way that we live Jesus is a fluid process that looks differently from one generation to another, from one season to another. And so this conspiracy of kindness is a challenge to rethink how we think about evangelism and to present a new vision, a simple strategy for sharing the message of Jesus' love in a way that can change people's lives forever. And so the heart of this new way of sharing the message of Jesus is through kindness. It's about being willing to serve others and create an atmosphere that is more about showing God's love, about being the church, about doing things that would help people to understand the love and the grace and the mercy of God, that they might come to know Jesus in a very real way. So over the next few weeks, we're going to be looking at this concept of kindness, being kind, extending kindness, creating an atmosphere that allows people to see Jesus and to begin to seek Jesus. So today I want to dig a little deeper into the power of kindness. So kindness is one of those words that we don't truly understand the meaning of. It's kind of like the word love. We tend to use words in a very broad sense, and the word love is an example of that. We say we love lots of things, including social media posts. But it doesn't mean that we love them. It just kind of means that we like them a little bit more than just like a strong like I really, really like. But creating a really, really like button seems silly, so we push it into a love button. And we use the word love a lot because it expresses a sentiment with a greater level of emotion. Yes? So we tend to do the same thing with the word kindness. But what most people mean when they say kindness is really niceness. But it feels weird to talk about niceness. And so we say the word kindness because it feels like it fits better. But the scriptures refer to kindness in a very specific matter. And they are very clear to point this out. Kindness is only something that God can do. And so our scripture text for this morning is from Galatians chapter 5, verses 22 and 23. Scripture says this, "But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, forbearance, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Against such things there is no law." So kindness is a fruit of the Spirit. It is something that is produced in us by the hand of God. And just like the other fruits of the Spirit, like love and joy and peace and forbearance, which we understand to be patience, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control, we're not capable of producing these fruits, these manifestations of God in our own power. They only come from God. They are characteristics of God, that the Spirit grows in us as we grow closer to God. As we come to know Him in deeper ways, these fruits that the Spirit grows in us begin to flow through us. We begin to become instruments of love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. These are things that only God can do. And sometimes we misunderstand the source of these things because in our humanness, we're bound by words. Words that we use to express these concepts, but these words often fail to communicate the true reality of the gift and of the giver. So kindness is something that flows from God through people who are open to being used by him. In Romans chapter 2, verse 4 says this, God's kindness leads you toward repentance. In other words, as we allow God's kindness to flow from us, that kindness brings with it the invitation to come closer to God. It breaks down the walls that keep us at a distance and offers us a wide open, spacious place to encounter the love and the mercy of Jesus. Jeremiah 21:3 says, I have loved you with an everlasting love. I have drawn you with unfailing kindness. You see, kindness is of God. He is the source of kindness, and his kindness has the power to change lives. So we talked a few weeks ago about the parable of the Good Samaritan. It's this story of a man who was robbed and left for dead on the side of the road, and many came that way but didn't stop to help him. And then a Samaritan who was walking along the road saw the man, and he stopped to help. And we often talk about how he went above and beyond to help the man, bandaging up his wounds, taking him into town, finding him a place to stay while he recovered from his injuries, and providing the financial resources needed to help this stranger. And this is an illustration, is an example of kindness. The kindness that comes from God and moves us to action. It motivates us to show the love of God in a practical way, not looking toward what we can gain from this situation, but simply letting God's love flow through us. And I have no doubt that an act of kindness like that would have had an incredible impact upon the one to whom the kindness was shown. Yes? So, would you think, just a minute, about a time in your life when kindness was shown to you? And I pray that God would bring those profound touches that have happened to us along the way in each of our lives. I pray that he would bring those to the forefronts of our minds right now. Maybe it was something huge. Maybe someone helped you when you were down on your luck. Maybe it was just something kind of small. Maybe someone went out of their way to encourage you or to bless you in a very small way, but it had a very big impact in your heart. You see, we are permanently touched by the kindness of God. And once we are touched, we are never the same after someone has shown us his kindness through their actions. Well, sometimes the things that make the deepest impact are the things that go unnoticed. In Matthew 25, Jesus is speaking to the sheep, and he commends them, saying, when I was thirsty, when I was hungry, when I was naked, you fed me, you gave me water, you clothed me. But then they replied, when, Lord? We don't remember doing that. And he said, when you did this to the least of these, you did it to me. You see, when we let the fruits of the Spirit flow through us, we end up living in an ever-increasing flow of kindness. So much so that we sometimes stop noticing that kindness flowing from us. And every person is uniquely wired, and we don't always know of methods that speak those deeper levels of love and life to another person. And so it's good that God has lots of different ways to show kindness through us as we walk in obedience to him. Mother Teresa once said, kind words can be short and easy to speak, but their echoes can truly be endless. So in this book, Conspiracy of Kindness, there are lots of practical examples of organized efforts, intentional ways to show the love of Jesus to people. And one that they talk about very frequently is that they set up somewhere to give away free cans of soda. And when people approach them, they simply ask, would you like regular or diet? And they hand out these drinks with a simple card that says, this is a way of showing that God loves you. There's no strings attached. And I wanted to share with you just a little story from this book, Conspiracy of Kindness. It says this. On this particular Saturday, we put together a free Coke giveaway and washed windshields at several locations around town. At Sunday services on the following day, a young guy in his mid-20s walked into the meeting carefully carrying an empty Coke can. He had a somewhat glazed look on his face. And so one of the regulars went over to meet him and offered to throw away the can for him. "Oh no, I'm not going to throw away this can. I'm saving this can. You see, this can is the can of Coke that the Christians gave me yesterday in order to show God's love to me." I don't know that man's full story, but it's clear that the simple act of giving away a cold drink at a stoplight in a conversation that lasted 10 seconds had made a significant impact on him. I believe that this man came much closer to having a relationship with Christ as a result of the kindness showed to him. I don't know whether he accepted Christ that Sunday, but I do know and I do believe that he is well on his way toward knowing Christ in a personal and dynamic way. See, you and I never really know what it is that will speak the love of Jesus at a deeper level to a human heart. Our part is to walk in obedience and to let God's kindness flow through us, that God may use these acts of kindness to bring people closer to himself. So that's the heart behind the event that we're hosting this next weekend, this Kids Fun Fest that Martha mentioned. It's really that we have the desire to show God's love for people in a practical way. So I hope that you will come out, that you'll come and serve, that you'll be part of this opportunity to have fun and to show God's love. And if there would be even just one word, just one act of kindness, just one conversation, just one interaction at this event that would help even one person come closer to Jesus, then every bit of it is worth it. Yes? Kindness comes from God, and as God's kindness moves through us, it has the power to change lives. So may we ask God to pour out his kindness through us today and every day. Amen? Let's pray. Father God, we thank you and we praise you for the opportunity that you give us to come into the presence, into your presence in your house today. God, the opportunity that you give us freely to walk in, to enter into your presence, to come close to you, to know you in a very real and a very personal way. God, sometimes we take that for granted. We're so grateful that your love for us is that big. We're so grateful for the blood of Jesus that made a way for us to be in relationship with you every minute of every day. God, I pray that you would help us to see kindness, to see evangelism, to see this commission that you've given us to go and share about you in a very real way. I pray that you would help us to be more mindful of that, to be more about that in our everyday lives, God. Help us to rethink what we've always learned about evangelism and to understand that just being kind, just letting your kindness flow through us can be all you need to change a human heart. God, we pray that you would use us to bring people closer to you, that you would use each and every one of our lives, the ups and the downs of life in this world, that you would use us to help point people to you. God, we thank you and we praise you for everything you are, and we give you glory and honor and praise in Jesus' name. Amen.